All right, I'm starting off with these questions to ponder slides, which are posted on your classroom. It's just loading up right now, but in this slide, I've actually added a couple of extra slides here, which give you a little bit more background around how I want you to be answering these questions. Really, really good responses include three basic things. The first is the statement. So I want you to restate the question in your own words, and then explain your position. So if I were to say, what is the best ice cream? Your restating would sound like, I think the best ice cream is, and then you would explain your position. The best ice cream is vanilla. And then the next part gets into the because. The other thing I really want to make sure is that you put it into your own words. So you don't have to copy out the question in full, but you can paraphrase it into your own language so that it's a reflection of you as a learner. The second part is the evidence. Now, it's not just enough to say that vanilla ice cream is your favorite ice cream. You actually have to use some specific examples, and in our case, it's from the giver, to back up why you think what you think. So you could use quotes to back up what you think, but it doesn't have to be a quote. You can be paraphrasing a section of the text. So in relation to the ice cream example, you could say, I think that the best ice cream is vanilla because it is simple, it goes with everything, and nobody has a problem with something as simple as a flavor as vanilla, so it pleases everybody for the most part. In relation to the giver, you could be asked a question like, do you think that this is a good society to live in? You would restate the question. Do I think this is a good society to live in? I do not think it is a good society to live in because there's not a lot of choice, because people are not treated with a lot of freedom, and I would not want to live in this society because I really like the idea of choosing my own career and that I could change careers or that I could move if I was unhappy or that I would be able to change my life if needed. Essentially, you're finding examples and explaining why you think what you think. The last part is probably the most important. It's you explaining how this piece of evidence supports your position. In other words, you're explaining the greater significance. You wrap up your point. So for example, back to the ice cream example. I think that vanilla ice cream is the best kind of ice cream out there because it is so simple, it goes with all other dessert foods. You can have it with a slice of pie, you could have it with cookies, and it just complements all other desserts so well. This obviously proves that vanilla ice cream is so versatile and anybody can like it. So that small little statement shows how my example supports my position. This piece helps to wrap up your entire statement. So it's like a conclusion in a way. Think about why the evidence matters. So this is an example, and I want you in your own time to look through this and to see how the pink is the statement, the orange is evidence, and the green is analysis. This is an example from a student in our class, and they did a really great job of including all of these things. But what I like about this example is that they didn't say the statement and then right after the evidence and then right after the analysis. You can see that there's some pink, and then there's some orange, and then there's some pink again, and then more orange. So it doesn't have to be so cut and dry like the example I gave you. You can fluidly include all three in your statement. But generally speaking, the analysis, the conclusion, should definitely come at the end. Your chapter questions are included in this document, so I've also given you a document to fill out that shows how to break down the statement, evidence, and analysis. So your reflection question submission is going to include little prompts for you to be able to practice using this kind of answering format. I'm excited to see your improved journal responses, and I think it's going to be a really great experience for you girls. Let me know if you've got any questions, and have fun.